Any country, religion, no, dancing, one colors, one love.
Oh yeah, what's up world? It's the Master G, y'all. Sugar Hill Gang, Wonder Mike, and Diggity. I'm out here with my man Bob Sinclair. We going back old school style on ya. All my party people, all my brothers, all my sisters, worldwide fans. Yeah, let's do it. Come on.
I think this city really needed a big explosive festival.
Our big plan is to make it the biggest and best dance festival in the world. Everything in it is international. Everything is either an international artist, an international company, or an international collaboration. And it's all about bringing the very best dance from around the world to Birmingham, and also participation on a grand scale with the people of Birmingham as well.
Well, I think in 2010, what we've done with the festival this time round is we looked at the 2008 festival and really took on what we did and what we had successes with, and really think, how can we expand on those successes, make even more of it? We knew that outdoor work was really popular in the first festival, so we've gone really a bit mad with outdoor work in this festival.
We've aimed to make it a much bigger, higher profile than it was in 2008, and we've extended the programme to include, you know, a lot more in terms of international artists and shows and so forth.
I was approached by David Massingham from Dance Exchange to bring together all these different folk groups to present world dance on the main stage for an outdoor event here in Victoria Square.
It's been a fantastic experience to work with dancers from all these different countries, just exchanging cultures, finding similarities between the different cultures, and finding ways to work with each other, you know, even though we're coming from very different backgrounds, very different kinds of training. And it's a fantastic experience to, you know, work through all of these things and still come up with something that's so beautiful.
It's gonna stay in memory for the rest of my life, for example, me.
The idea is to go from an invisible intervention in the street to a mass event on the last day.
I really don't know what I just saw, but you know, because it was kind of different, it's unique to any other kind of performances. You know, it was, I didn't know who was in the play because there's so much people around, they mixed it, they blended it well. You know, it was different, unique.
If you're in the street, then you're really open to any reaction whatsoever, so you have to be quite steady.
Yes. Yeah.
Gradually unfolded, and I think they must have been amazed, actually. I would have been, I mean, and they were captivated, I think, a lot of them, you know.
It was really, really quite awesome, really, you know, just like this huge dance thing. So they were all like darting through all the people in the streets and stuff. It was almost like, you know, just came out of nowhere.
Hold her tight. The top of the boat is a hazard. Watch out, the tunnels are low. They might knock you into the water. That's not the place to go. Oddball, oddball, where are we going today? Let's be on our way.
It's the first time we've ever seen any dancing on any canal boats or on the waterways. It's not something you'd normally see.
Did you like the song?
Yeah.
Yeah, you liked the song?
Yeah.
Who wants it again?
We've been putting even more dance into the venues. I think there's over double the amount of stage works as well.
The festival has always been not just about contemporary or any one type of dance. It's always been about the full range of dance.
After the show, we did a dance workshop and we delivered it to the general members of the public that were watching the show.
We ain't shy or anything, so we just thought we'd take part for the fun of it.
The kids, the energy of the kids coming
guys,
in.
They just loved it.
They
The young teenagers, they really got involved. It's about audience participation, and instead of just delivering, you can give back.
We would like you to learn a dance routine. There's an event happening called Put Your Foot Down, and it's going to be the grand finale of the International Dance Festival Birmingham, where you get to learn a routine, and then there'll be a mass performance here a little later on.
Events like today and give everyone an opportunity to participate.
Yeah, I really think that Put Your Foot Down is the end of the festival. We wanted it anyway, the big, explosive, dynamic bash, really.
I'm really glad to be here today, because it's the real thing back of me with the meeting with the people and exchange dancing.
Run it, just jump, jump, clap now. Run it, and jump, jump, clap. One time, two times, three times, four times. Everybody get ready for the second set.
I think it's an amazing festival. And it's a much bigger festival than the first one in 2008. It has grown so much. I mean, the variety of shows and events and opportunities to experience, participate, watch, learn more about dance, it's incredible. I don't think there is any other festival like this in the UK.
I'm so pleased. Everyone worked so hard on this, but I think we've got the reward. You know, as I say, audiences have doubled, which is amazing, and we've been able to pretty much do everything that we set out to do, and probably more, I would think. So we're very, very pleased with the way things have gone.
But we needed something like IDFB to really be able to show the world just how ambitious our dance sector is and how many connections we have with dance artists from all over the world.
One dance, two dance, and everybody take your hands.